rules of procedure said, the president of council shall preserve order in the quorum. He or she may order the expulsion of any person for violation of these rules, disruptive behavior, or any works or action which incite violence or disorder, subject to appeal to council. Any person so expelled shall not be readmitted to the remainder of the meeting from which expelled. Any person who has been so expelled and who at a later meeting again engages in words or actions justifying expulsion may also be barred from attendance at future meetings of council for a specified reasonable period of time, not to exceed 6 months. And we have used this rule in the past.
But you sent a letter out to the person, right? And we didn't know anything about the letter.
It says that is my priority to do that if I feel that someone has engaged in behavior that has disrupted our meetings more than once.
I don't think it's fair. But the person was not given a warning. The person did not do anything first day that would have led her to be arrested in here. You know, and if you want to blame somebody, I think it should have been blamed on me.
But Mr. Amel, the person that we're discussing has the right to appeal to council.
She has the right to appeal to this council? Heck, when she's not allowed even to come in here.
How does she appeal? Does she appeal for council president?
If it's an appeal that's taken by any member of council, it's considered a ruling by the chair of the body, and the appeal is by a member of council, and in effect on behalf of the individual. But it's an appeal that's taken by any member of council.
So would you like to have us vote on this, Ms. Carroll?
You're not making everything clear yet, Kathy.
Okay.
I don't know what the heck this is.
Okay. What happens if a person is disruptive 2 meetings in a row? And we have done it before, as you know, Mr. Trammell. We have, to maintain order in the council, we have said this person cannot come back for X amount of time. And that has happened to me. That person has the right to appeal to you, the council person. And you can bring it up and see if your fellow council members agree with that person not coming to council for X amount of time.
The other person, I think, that you're talking about was escorted out of here because that person wanted to fight another council person. This person did not try to fight anyone. She was just voicing her opinions. And I don't think that we gave her any kind of warning. The police did not escort her out of here. I went behind her. And I think, Martin, did you? Martin. But she did not threaten to hurt us or to fight us. And sure, some of the things that she says, I think because she was not on her medicine, she did not have money to buy it.
Ms. Trammell, when we had council meetings,
you need to make it known that, hey, if anybody here has got a problem about the Redskins or the West Hampton School that's not allowed to come out here and speak their mind because they're going to be escorted out of here and then barred from city council meetings.
Yeah, somebody can come and do that tonight, but it's fine.
Why?
They come in 2 weeks and do it a second time.
You can't make that clear to that person.
And have the meeting totally disrupted, and us have to go into recess twice in 4 weeks, two meetings, both meetings we have to go into recess because of the behavior of this person. No, it was not violent. No, it was not threatening. Yes, it was very, very disruptive. The entire proceedings going on in council. People come down to council with serious issues. People come down to council just as they will tonight to speak to papers and to have that disruptive behavior going on in the council meeting is not fair to the other citizens sitting in the audience.
It's not fair that you didn't make that clear. It's not fair that you wrote that person a letter explaining yourself, but they're asking us, or letting us know anything about it, and now it's not fair that this person did not know the process that the city attorneys just gave us, that person or others are not here to even hear what he had to say. So I want to bring bring it up, that we let her come back, provided that she does not disrupt another council meeting, or even not let her speak, let her be here. Because I don't think the procedure was done fair. And
Madam Chair,
yes,
Madam President, may I ask a question this evening?
Please.
Mr. Attorney, are there any requirements in city code, charter, or in our adopted rules that dictate a time when an appeal from the president's decision may be taken?
There are no time limits that are specified by state law or by the rules of procedure themselves. When your rules are silent, Robert's rules run to apply. Robert's rules ordinarily contemplate an appeal during a meeting. This occurred between meetings, and so this is as appropriate time to bring it up.
So this letter was sent out, I think, on November 7th. The next meeting, from actions taken the previous 2 weeks previous, and
every member of council got a copy.
And November 12th would have been the next meeting of council. Is that right?
Yes, that would have been the next meeting. What I don't know is when either the individual or the members of the council actually received the letter.
Madam President.
Yes, sir.
I need to know from the attorney also. There's nothing in our rules that says anything about two times disruptive, is it? Mm-hmm.
Yes, it does.
Yes, sir.
I can read it again.
Rule procedure deals with second expulsions.
That this second expulsion.
This remedy is available when a person is expelled for a second time.
Well, this person hadn't been expelled before.
Mm-hmm. Twice. That was her second. That was the second time.
Wait.
Two. We've had 4 weeks ago. It must have been 4 weeks.
The letter indicates July 9th, and then again on October 22nd. The rules do not require me in consecutive meetings. Simply requires 2 meetings.
No, I get that, but I'm not aware of her being expelled. So she was quieted down, but not expelled. What constitutes expelling?
It doesn't
actually escort her out of the building.
It doesn't require expulsion. It requires the president of council shall order the expulsion. So if the president says, in umpire speak, that's it, you're out of here, even if the person refuses to go, the order of expulsion has been made.
That last question, and that is, for an appeal to be brought by a member of the council, is that a simple motion? Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
And can we vote on it in
So, Ms. Trammell,
can we vote on it informal, or can we do that formal?
You can do it right here.
Ms. Trammell might want to put together a case first before she puts a motion on it. Well, it doesn't have to be tonight, does it?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Madam President.
Yes, ma'am.
I want to send the word out that people can come down here and abuse us and things like that. I do not want that. Not from anyone. From Richmond, Chesapeake, anywhere, because it's not fair. Other counties don't allow it. I don't want that. I want to send out the wrong message that they can come here and just add numbers and say things that are not true to make up things. All I'm saying, I don't think the process was done. I just don't think that we gave her a fair warning. And I think now that we must let it be known that you're not going to come down here, it doesn't matter who he or she, whoever it is, not going to come down here and attack us in any kind of way that's not professional or whatever. But still, with her, she was not escorted out, but not twice in a row. And maybe I should not have said something, but I did because I felt like I knew that she didn't have the money for us. I do know that.
Well, why don't you and I talk about it offline? I'm sorry, what? You said, why don't you and I talk about it offline, not here, but we'll talk about that at the meeting. Okay. All right, now, I see a lot of students in the room. And so I guess